Hello guys, welcome to my channel HUI tutorials. In this video I will explain about how we can perform the mouse actions using flaui. In some scenarios we may face a situation where we need to perform the click operations using mouse. So how are we going to do that? Further, flaui is providing one class, that is mouse helper class. Using this mouse helper class we can perform mouse related actions. The mouse helper class name is mouse. Okay, so let me open my Visual Studio. So first let me create one method, test method. The mouse class will be present in this location. First, we'll see how we can perform the left click operation using this mouse. Mouse dot, you can write left click. So if you are not passing any parameter to this left click method, it will by default consider the current mouse position and it will perform left click there. If you wanted to perform the left click operation at a particular point, then you can pass the location to this left click, the mouse pointer location. Or you can perform mouse hover action first, then you can perform the left click. There are two ways. Okay. So first we'll see without passing any location, how do we perform the left click? So for this, what I will do after running this test, I will simply move the mouse to this, any of this test method, and we'll see whether left click will actually select this test case or not. Okay. Let me run the test. So you can see this test find methods actually selected. So that is how we perform the left click, and we'll see how we can do the right click also. So this is also similar to left click, but it will perform the right click operation. Okay. So I'll move the mouse pointer to this one and we'll see. You can see it performed the right click operation and provided the menu also. Let me show you how we can perform left click with a specific position. Okay. So the left click, you need to pass the point. So you can create the point here. So this point will be available under this package. Point, I'll name it as point. New point. So you can pass the x-axis and y-axis. So how we are going to get this x-axis and y-axis locations? Okay. So further, I have created one application, that is where is my cursor. So with this application, you can get the x and y values. So let me open that. So before that, how do you get this application? So I have put this application under flaui test resources. So once you check out this flaui test project, you'll be getting this where is my cursor application also. So let me open that. So the application UI looks like this, a small pop-up, and when you are moving your mouse automatically, it will show you the X and Y axis values here. Okay. So for this, now I wanted to perform the left click by passing this value, this pointer location. So I wanted to select this test basic controls. Okay. So if you see the location is position X is 2063 by 245. So you can pass this location 2063 by 245. So let me pass this point to this mouse left click. Now we'll run the test case. You can see my mouse pointer is a test mouse, but now it moved to test basic controls, then it performed left click operation, right? So the similar way you can perform the right click operation also. Okay. You can see the right click operation is performed on test basic controls. Okay, so now we'll see how we can perform the middle click. We saw left click and right click. Okay, so for middle click, unfortunately, we don't have a direct method. When you type middle click, you don't have that method. So how are we going to achieve this? There is a generic method that is click. So for this click, you can pass the mouse button. So the mouse button is either left or right or middle. So you can pass the middle button to this one. Okay, so for showing you how, whether it is performing the middle click or not. So if I middle click on any of this thing, you don't see the difference. Okay, but if I middle click on this unittest.cs file here, it will close the file. Okay, so we will first get the location of this point, then we'll perform the middle click operation. So if you see here, 2298 by 82. 2298 by 82. So now with this, we can perform the middle click. We have created a point, but we haven't moved the click operation to the point. So here we can pass this point so that it will move the mouse to that point. Then it will perform the middle click operation. So you can see the file is closed. That means it moved the mouse to the location and performed the click operation, middle click operation. Okay. So the similar way, you can perform left click also from here and right also from here. In some scenarios, you don't want to perform click operation. You simply wanted to move the mouse. So how do we do that? For moving the mouse, we have two methods. Mouse dot move by and move to. So here there's a difference between this move by and move to. In move by, you can pass the location how much you wanted to move the cursor. So if your cursor location is 500 by 500 and if you pass 50 by 50, then it will move the mouse to 550 comma 550. Because you are saying move the mouse pointer in x-axis 50 points and y-axis also 50 points. So this will consider the current location and move to the new location by adding the values. In move to, you can directly provide the new location of the cursor. Okay. So first we'll see move by. I'll give something like 100 comma 100. So I wanted to move x-axis 100 points and y-axis also 100 points from the current position. Okay, so let me run this. So you can see the mouse pointer is moved, right? So similar way, we'll use mouse 2. I'll say something like 1500 by 100. Now you can see the difference. So the mouse pointer is moved, right? So this is the difference between move by and move to. In move to, you will provide the new location directly. In move by, you will provide the value on how much you wanted to move the mouse. So in move to, you can also provide the point value directly. So you can see here, I can directly pass the point value also. You can provide the values directly or you can pass the point value. You can create the point instance and pass it. So in this way, it should actually move to this location, right? We'll see. It moved the mouse pointer to this location, unittest1.cs. So here, if you see, the mouse pointer is moving. The action, the movement action also you can see. It is moving something like this, okay? But if you wanted to directly set the mouse pointer to some particular location, how do you do? So in this scenario, whatever we saw now, in that, if you say from this location to this location, it is moving the mouse like this. Okay. But if I wanted to directly put this mouse location directly to here without seeing any movement, there is a way. So that is, you can set the mouse position, mouse dot position equal point. So this time you don't see the movement. The mouse pointer will disappear here and it will appear here. Okay. So you can see it does this action in a fraction of a second, but it will not use the direct movement operation. It will directly set the mouse location to that. Okay. What else we can perform using mouse? We can perform scroll operations. So this one, right? So how do we do that? Mouse dot scroll. So here we need to pass the lines by how many lines we wanted to move the scrolling. Okay, so let's say 10. So here, if you pass the value as a positive value, the scroll will be moving to upside. If you pass the negative value, the scroll will be moving to downside. Okay. Scroll up and scroll down. The positive will do the scroll up, negative will do the scroll down. So let's see scroll up first. So let me run this test. So you can see it scrolled. Okay. So now we'll see scroll down. So that is, we need to pass negative value. So I'll say minus 10. So you can see it performed the scroll down operation as well. Okay. So we have two types of scrolls actually, right? So one is a horizontal scroll and another one is vertical scroll. So you can see this is a vertical scroll that we saw now. And there is another one that is horizontal scroll, this one. So let's see how we can perform horizontal scroll. For that, we have a method that is horizontal scroll. The similar way you can pass the lines. So I'll say some 30 lines or I'll say 50 lines because we are doing horizontally. So we have to move this much. Okay, let me run this. So you can see there is a movement in the horizontal one. Okay. So this is how we need to perform the scroll operations. Okay, that's it guys. So please practice this session and let me know if you have any queries in the comment section below. Thank you. Bye bye.
I hope you enjoy this session. If you like this video, please hit the like button and also share it with your friends. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.